Hello, hello. I have had a hell of a night. I actually got a very good night's sleep, or day's sleep, I should say. And I thought, oh great, I'll be all productive tonight because I'm completely rested. All the bad energy is gone and I can be productive, and didn't quite turn out that way. I started to have delusional thoughts, and then I took some Klonopin to take care of it, and it just ended up spacing out really for a long period of time, and freaking out at the fact that I couldn't even update my Facebook status without thinking that I sounded really stupid. So it's 5:41 a.m. Gonna move this chair over. I was genuinely worried that I would not be able to practice. And by the way, I'm wearing these funny clothes because Melissa said I should go shirtless or something for one of my practices, and I'm not going to do that to you. I know you don't want to see that. I got a lot of insight into examining my life, but I really thought about it a lot. My mom says, you know what they say at AA, and she says what they say at AA is to just take it one day at a time. I feel like, okay, I was trying to describe how I'm having this, like, I feel like it's not a delusion, but like if you've ever done drugs, like you feel stoned. You know, I do feel stoned from the Klonopin, but it's not stoned. It's like not really a trip. It's not like a psychedelic trip. It's just I feel like I'm in a different, like the room has been renovated. My environment is different, and I know I've been in this different environment for a while, but I feel different. I feel like I'm in a different world. And when I say that, I mean, like, obviously I know it's the same planet. I don't have any thought that I died and then woke up in a different dimension. But I feel like, I don't know. That's basically all I can say about it, because I don't have the words to tell you how I feel. So I was talking, that was the camera that shut it off. You can trust me. You'll learn to trust me, I don't lie. So I was talking to my good friend about how I should get a haircut, and how I have this whole psychological complex about not getting a haircut, and blah, blah, blah. Thank you. people will probably give me pointers based on that, saying, here's how you do that the right way. But to me, I don't know if the camera picked it up, but I liked that sound. And I know you're supposed to let the audience judge, but I'm sorry, it's just a natural instinct. I'm probably more audience than the actual audience is, just because I'm so new to playing guitar. So, like, yeah, if I heard someone else make these guitar sounds, I'd be like, who cares? That's basic. But the fact that it's me that's making them, it's like, whoa, man. Yeah, you know, all that, it came out of me, no, it was the guitar, blah, 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 blah. I hope you can see the fretboard. And you know, all that stuff. Earlier, I was not saying people's names to protect identity. If I ever say anything and you think I'm talking to you, you can ask me about it. I probably won't remember, but there's a good chance I've had similar conversations with a group of different people. I talk to a lot of people. My talking to the camera is kind of like me unloading everything that went through my day, and I may not be talking about you even if what I'm saying applies to you. I hope that's not too hard to understand. Just picture, I imagine like most of the people I talk to other people. And you know, I've talked to people on the internet for a long time, and sometimes you're having five wildly different conversations. And sometimes there's just something on your mind that you need to work through, and you talk to everybody about it. Anyways. So. Just. Like I said, I've had a rough night, and I've had, in fact, many rough nights in a row, and if I ever say something that sounds like I'm disparaging someone, first of all, I respect everybody who, like, I respect, at least to some degree, anyone who talks to me, unless I'm, like, if I don't respect you, I'll delete you or whatever. And so, you know, and by respect, that's a form of love. You know, people are hesitant to say I love you because it implies like, oh no, is this going to go somewhere sexual? But, you know, I think most people at least have heard of the concept of like platonic love and blah, blah, blah. And then you go through the phase where like, oh, I platonically love you, and then it starts to get sexual, but I'm not, no, I have a girlfriend. I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm just letting the words flow. The point is, I respect people. Facebook is very smart to have the like button. Tumblr has the love button. I don't know if that causes any trouble, but same deal. Like, yeah, don't think about it too much. And if you're a creepy guy who is in love with me, I mean, that's okay, but obviously I have my boundaries. Yeah, so anyways. Since I just said something that could be, I think I just went on a long emotional rant, and I think some people who, if I were listening to that rant, and I heard it coming out of my mouth, so I heard, fuck, I was gonna say something very good and clever about, yeah, just, basically calm down. Picture me as Matt Damon. You may love Matt Damon either because he shoots guns and I'm Matt Damon too, or because like you're actually in love with Matt Damon, which a 7-Eleven clerk accused me of because I bought one DVD of his and she's like, "That's your guy, eh?" And I'm like, "Dude, no, wait, whoa, I'm just buying a movie." Anyways, picture me as Matt Damon, someone you can watch and enjoy and never see in real life. I'm thinking of like just boarding up the windows and, I don't know, getting grocery gateway to deliver food. That's kind of a joke, but it's kind of how my life might play out if I'm not careful. There's this bartender in my area. It was when I was first like going to bars by myself because I was a depraved alcoholic. And I was isolated back then too, and I would talk to the bartender so he was getting to know me, and I'm like, "Oh, this is nice, it's like I'm paying him to be my friend." And it turns out, no, I'm not paying him to be my friend, I'm paying him for him to give me a beer, which I will drink, and then, you know, beer's good. Said I would never pay someone to be my friend unless I was like a prince. If I were like Prince Charles, for sure Prince Charles, Prince William, and Prince Henry, I forget, but like for sure they have people who hang around them they probably don't think of it as a friend thing, it's like a consultant, but they probably pay for consultants. Anyways, wow, I'm getting really stressed out just talking about everyday stuff. Because I, like I was saying, I'm in a different world. I woke up after a long sleep, after many nights of insomnia, and I felt like I was in a different world. That's the easiest way to explain it. And now I have all these things to say, and I guess they were in the back of my mind, and I never really dealt with them, and... Yeah, like when you get really depressed, you start thinking like, oh, everyone's out for themselves, and but there are actually good people, and there are people who sometimes do things for themselves and sometimes do things for others out of the goodness of their heart, blah, 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 atheism versus religion, blah, 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 blah. I don't care. Saying sometimes the chit chat's got to stop. I think I should listen to that advice with the guitar videos because I keep putting my foot in my mouth. And then I admit that I put my foot in my mouth, and people are like, why did you say that? And they say it anyways. But yeah, I don't expect people to watch the whole video. Or maybe they did, but what I said was just so profoundly insulting to them, and I'm sorry if something I say is profoundly insulting to you. Please keep in mind that I'm apologizing as much as I'm making like forward positive statements towards some kind of belief. I'm making statements about a belief and then apologizing for them. So keep in mind that I am also a delicate flower. Say that is extremely general, like extremely, like it seems to be one of the big topics being talked about today, and it annoys me that it is because it's so simplistic. The concept of the alpha male and the beta male, and I guess like relating human masculinity to the animal kingdom of, I guess, like wolves or whatever, there's the alpha wolf. That seems, it is or was, I think some people started talking about it, then other people started talking about it, and the first people who were talking about it stopped talking about it. Anyways, that's such an unhealthy way of looking at the world, and if you actually do glorify the alpha male, maybe the people talking about this know this, but the real alpha male, that guy is serving a life sentence for like hideous crimes. So just keep that in mind. Think about it. Think about it. Okay, so I thought this was a good filter for the camera, but it's doing this stuff again. Executives out there, or like producers or writers, whatever, who are going through these YouTubes of all these socially isolated people and listening to the people who actually talk and then forming a character which they'll teach an actor for their NBC television show to play. And what if that's happening to me right now? Ooh, but wouldn't it be better if I was the actor? But yeah, maybe I don't want to be the actor. I don't know. I don't think I ever want to be really famous for a number of reasons. Although, the way I, like I'm making videos for the public. So, I don't know, I guess I just, I know fame is something that might happen to me, but when I've like gotten drunk, gotten high, listened to interviews with all these actors because I've watched every single movie that came out that summer, and I've watched every single television show, and all that's left is to listen to the actors talk to Entertainment Tonight. I've been that guy, and so, actors generally say, it kinda really sucks to be famous. And I can believe them, based on just paranoid thought that people in my neighborhood are like looking at me a certain way. Which is, my psychiatrist actually said that might not be paranoid, but I think it's a lot healthier to believe that I am essentially anonymous. So many dials to play with. Like, obviously the guitar has been around for a long time, and I have this like conception in my head that it wasn't around before like 1900, but I'm pretty sure it was. Like, I'm pretty sure it was at least medieval. I mean, there's different kinds of guitars. I don't know. I guess it's an evolution thing. But yeah, for me, like, one of the reasons I didn't want to even try to learn guitar at first was just like the idea of six strings and what, I don't know how many frets there are. I could count right now to find out, but it doesn't matter. Just that alone, that's a lot of stuff to think about. That you have to think about, if you're going to master this thing, you have to think about, I guess you have to know internally what every sound, like, what that sounds like, what that sounds like, that sounds like, all the way down, and then the next string all the way down, like for mastery, this is what I think you need to know. You need to, by heart, know with certainty what sound each note will make. And then I think if you have that deep of knowledge, you will kind of... the idea of learning chords, once you get that deep into knowing the guitar, that's not a separate task that will you'll already know. And then you have to know like rhythm for the strumming. And then, to top that off, I mean, I didn't purposely buy this guitar, but I think this is a fairly standard beginner's guitar. And then you've got this thing, which changes everything. And you've got two tones, and you've got the volume. And so you've basically got like, I don't know, I'd say at least 5 years work to get an intermediate understanding of this guitar. So you can't see the... Yeah, anyways. Where were we? We were supposed to be practicing and we're vlogging. So, if I can say something controversial, I just explained how the guitar is very complicated. In opposition to that, as a like 8-year-old, I learned some piano, and I never really found the piano that daunting. I thought, okay, here's this. First of all, it was like a real piano. It wasn't an electronic piano. But here's this piano. We got to get some guy in to get it tuned sometimes. It's like hiring a cleaning lady or something. And like, I was cool with that. I didn't understand the concept of DIY and stuff like that. But I thought, all right, that's whatever. And then you've got like, what, maybe like 50 keys? So if you got 50 keys, I'm pretty sure this is more than 50 keys. I don't know. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and then I don't know if that counts as 22. So let's say 21 times 6, 2 times 6 is 120, so 126, you have 126 notes on this guitar, and that's without turning either of the two tones, the tones which can go from 1 to 10, or flipping this thing. That's how complicated it is. But at the same time, I guess it's as simple as... I mean, no one's going to pay to see you do that, but whatever. Not that. People, I think when I just said that, some people are going to assume I want to be paid to play guitar. and I can't really explain what I want out of the guitar, but I'm going to say just officially that I don't want to be famous, I don't want to be paid. I want to learn, I enjoy learning. There's certain emotional connections to me learning the guitar and the stress it relieves from my isolation, blah, blah, blah. I could talk a lot about reasons that are not fame and money. And of course, you'll think I'm just lying and it's just fame and money because that's what everyone wants. Fuck, I gotta stop thinking about this. I just want to mention that whenever I call Melissa by a text message, we see each other on the weekends, so we text a lot, that I'm about to practice guitar. She goes, "Oh, small rock star boy." I mean, she uses a more positive feminine voice, but out of respect, I wasn't imitating that. And what I just said sounds disrespectful. I'm sorry if you're disrespected. Please, I know I'm a bad person. We're all sinners. The thing is, like, a lot of political opinion, like, is basically a regurgitation of what I was led to believe. Like, I don't know, I haven't actually read most of the Bible. But what I was led to believe, it's very Bible-based, it seems. A lot of political opinion. Yeah, the Bible is very much forbidden from me. And I know people have a lot of legitimate reasons, extremely legitimate reasons, why they're against the Bible. And all I can say is I wasn't raised that way, so I guess I'm lucky that I didn't have all those bad experiences that seem to happen from being in a society that bases itself around the Bible. But at the same time, like, Bible and other religion and just religion in general, it's just like anywhere you turn, it's gonna come up, someone's gonna talk about it. And I went through like at least 15 years hearing it, and my mom say, "No, it's just fake," and but you just hear it on the TV over and over again, or newspapers, whatever, just everyone talks about. You can't escape life without knowing that religion exists, and hearing how millions of people are believers, when it seems everyone around you is a non-believer. But you can't escape hearing it, and you ask, like, well, maybe I should look into that, and then you start to look into it, and people start freaking out and being like, "Dude, don't be that guy. Don't be that guy, dude. Put the Bible down." So, okay, I think that's enough on E, D, A, and C. I'm really not sure it was my intention to play them all twice, and I keep talking. So maybe we should shut up a bit. You know what I'm naming the video. I really must be stoned from the anxiety pills because I don't remember what I've done and what I haven't done. Thank you. Dead air, man. Suggested that technique. Even though I am strained from it so much, but like they say, you have to learn it the right way before you can do it the wrong way, which I always hated, but at least I can. And you're gonna tell me I did actually learn it the right way. You know, whatever. I'm sure. I just work based on the assumption that all the things I do wrong, the people who are teaching me, they've also done wrong, or maybe they forget doing it wrong themselves, or just. I work on the assumption they know what it is to be doing something wrong and thinking that you're right. So if they can empathize with the fact that, if you can empathize with the fact that a person who smashes a TV and then delivers it to someone's house who is in need of food and says to the person, "Here's your food, the smashed TV." If you can empathize with the fact that someone would do this out of ignorance, then you can empathize with me. You're not funny, man. If you have anything to say about what happens in this video, leave it in the YouTube comment section, and I will try to reply if it's not just you spewing hate. I would rather not get into discussions about things I did like 2 days ago. And remember, this is not directed at anyone specifically. What have we done? We're almost past this part. Don't worry, don't worry. Short and not go over F twice, because I feel like I've been really stretching this out, and we're gonna go to the second chart. Something I haven't done before. If you've watched the videos, you may know what I'm talking about, the difference there. Enough of that, and I realize I've been doing this for a while, not actually looking at how it's formally supposed to be done, but I am fairly sure I'm doing it the right way. Notes played incorrectly, but I don't care because it sounds close enough. I have been way too abusive towards the integrity of the song. just because I want to be able to make it sound like how it sounds on TV. I want to be on TV. And anyone who would care about me saying this isn't watching, but it's really hard to say this, the guitar actually gives me a small amount, I don't know if I even should say this, there's something spiritual about, no, okay, yeah, that's just, never mind. I'm sorry, I hope I haven't cursed myself. Most of them freaked out, and I'm just realizing now I should apologize if any of my emotional distress caused the viewer, emotional distress. Obviously, I'm intending to, or I would like my music to be enjoyable, and this practice session is creating emotion. Well, it's me purging, me throwing up in onto the camera. Don't throw up unless you need to. Jesus. It's me purging the negative emotions onto the camera. And so I'm sorry if some of that got on your face and was like, ew. Now I have to, I'm talking about mud, by the way. anyways, I have zits on my face from stress and maybe from eating dirt, I don't know. I'm just trying to find a good way to end this video without it being too weird, but okay, so there's these chords.
There's these chords, I know.
Okay. Thank you, everybody. I want to thank everyone throughout my life. Okay, I'm just going to sound crazy here, so I'm going to shut up.